In this tutorial, we're going to install Linux Mint Mate 17.1 with no codecs, alongside of Windows XP. We call that dual booting the machine. Before we start, I want to point out that you want to do a backup of your Windows XP machine. You can use Macrium Reflect Free, Todo Backup Free 8.2. There's also Clonezilla, so we've got three different choices. One of them should work for you. Now we're ready to install the system. I'm going to right-click on Install and Open. It's asking us for the language. I want English. Continue. Now it's checking to see that we've got at least 8.3 gigabytes available. We do. And that we're connected to the internet. We don't need to be connected to the internet to install Linux Mint. While we're on the screen, I want to point out this blank area here and go back to the Linux Mint download page. Remember this little asterisk for the no codecs, and we came down here. It says missing codecs and extra applications can be installed with a simple click of the mouse. I've got a picture here of the Ubuntu Mate installation process. Opening that up shows us a similar screen preparing to install Ubuntu. It checks the disk size and if we're connected to the internet. And right below that, we've got two checkboxes. One says download updates while installing. And the second one is the one that we're really interested in because that says install this third-party software. And this is for the extra audio and video plugins. We do not see that on our Linux Mate no codecs installer. We will continue. Now the installer has detected that we have Microsoft XP already on this computer. It's asking us if we want to install Linux Mint alongside Microsoft XP. That's what we want to do. If you don't care and want to wipe it out, you can check this next one that says erase the entire disk and install Linux Mint, giving it the entire disk. We want to install Linux Mint alongside Microsoft XP. Continue. This screen is actually showing us the hard drive is about 250 gigabytes. It wants to give 129 for Windows XP and 120 for Linux Mint. If I want to change that, I can grab this center, move it to the left a little bit or to the right. I'm going to give Linux Mint 160 gigabytes, and Microsoft Windows, 89. I'll click Install now. What this is asking us is if we want to repartition the hard drive. We do, but what the partition means is we're going to make that one 250 gigabyte hard drive act as if it's two separate hard drives. So we will have an SDA for system device A, which will be the Microsoft XP, and SD2, System Device 2, will be Linux Mint. It's only one physical hard drive, but partitioning that makes the computer think that it's actually two separate hard drives. I want to do this. I will click Continue. What this is telling us here is on the new Linux partition, we actually want to split it into two partitions. We want to have a swap area and a Linux Mint area. The Linux Mint area will be formatted as ext4. The swap area, that is just an area to store extra memory, kind of like when you're doing cut and paste. When you cut it, it stores it in memory, and if there's not enough memory, it wants to write that out to disk just temporarily until you do that paste. So the swap area is temporary memory storage. A lot of the computers with 6 or 8 gigabytes of memory don't really need a swap area. My computer's a little older, and I believe it still requires a swap area. Continue. It's asking us what time zone am I in. I'm in the New York time zone, and I will continue. Now it's asking about my keyboard layout. English, English US. Continue. Now it's asking me my name. I will put in Michael. The computer name is Optiplex 755. That's fine. It's picking a username. Notice this is all lowercase. Your username must be all lowercase. And then I'm going to put in a password. Down below that, we can have this log in automatically. And if I live alone and don't have anything important on my computer, I might want to choose that option. I am going to choose Require My Password to log in. This last checkbox means Encrypt My Home Folder. Remember in the last video how we went in through Linux and we could see the files on that Windows computer? Well, if we click Encrypt, you can't get into those files. They will be totally encrypted, which is great for security, but bad if you have a hard drive crash and need to recover some files. I think that a simple password to log in is enough security for me. I will not encrypt my home folder and click Continue. Now it's copying in files, and we've got a little slideshow up here. Tells us a little bit about Linux Mint. So our installation is complete. I will click Restart Now and restart my computer. I've restarted my computer and it brings up this screen. If I don't do anything, it will boot into Linux Mint Mate after 5 seconds. If I click my arrow down and back up, like I just did, it will wait for me to select an option and press Enter. If I want to start Windows, I'll press my arrow key down and press Enter here. The default is Linux Mate 17.1 that we just installed. This screen we're looking at is called the GRUB screen. GRUB stands for Grand Unified Bootloader. If you have a newer computer with UEFI, this process will look different to you. This tutorial series is from Windows XP to Linux, and Windows XP machines should have this GRUB screen. I'll hit Enter and log in. We've logged in to Linux Mint 17.1 for the first time. We have this welcome screen here. Remember earlier in the tutorial where I showed Ubuntu Mate had a checkbox to install the multimedia codecs? Well, Linux Mint Mate has the box right here. I need to double click on this icon, Install Multimedia Codecs. I'm double clicking that. It's asking for the password. Now it's asking us if we want to install additional software. I'll click Install. It's asking me for the password. And it's downloading the files. And now it's installing them. Now we're done. We should have the same version as the people that downloaded the 17.1 codecs version of Linux Mint Mate. In the next tutorial, we'll look at the first thing we should do after installing a new version of Linux.